Hello, hello, I'm Chris, and welcome back to more Satisfactory. So last time we had just gotten started, update 8 has just launched as of earlier today, so we're continuing on with our brand new start. Today, I kind of want to organize our mess that we have going and get done with our tier 2 of the milestones. So we have a few more. We only had 3 last episode. We got 5 this time. But they're all pretty easy, all pretty basic. So in between episodes, I did a little bit of building here. I expanded our power grid just a little bit. Got us a platform to set up on, help organize things. And today I want to start off by organizing this mess. We have logistics, we have base building, we have some basic supplies. So we should be good enough to get things rolling. I would like some more concrete. So that's what we're going to work on first. We're going to get that going. Because right now we're producing more limestone than we're using, and it is a very simple fix to get that going. So I'm just going to start by clearing this up, and then I need foundations. Just going to lock those to the grid, plop them down, and then right here we need constructors. So I'm going to grab a splitter, pop that down right in the middle, and then just wire it up. Boom. We need some power. And then, do we have what we need for 2 constructors? We do not. It's okay, we should have the supplies we need to build what we need. So I just need 2 more plates and a bunch of cable. That is another thing we're going to have to add to the list. Screws and cable are a couple things we need to start manufacturing today. I think I just want them, like, as close as possible, right? Those can 90 degree either way in there. These will both be concrete. So I want to make 10 per minute. Yep. These are both going to be 10 per minute. And I'll fill them up, wire them up, and merge them. A nice 90 degree bend into storage container. There we go. All set. So our concrete is going much better now. Underclocking the machines so that we take full advantage of the node, as we're producing 60 here and 30 and 30 are being used. Fully efficient over here. We can overclock that later, but for now that will do. Now, I need to get working on, I want to get iron plates set up a little better. So instead of this rinky-dink little thing, I think I want to bring it over here though. Out of concrete. This is why concrete was the first thing I changed. See, now we're producing concrete at a decent pace. So this stuff is in the way. It won't be for long. As soon as we get obstacle clearing. What do I want? I want smelters. So we're going to grab 2 smelters. After we get our splitter. Splitter I want right here. Will that reach? No. How about we do this then? Now it'll... Yeah, there we go. Like I was saying, we want smelters. I want these pretty close to the splitter. Is that close? A little closer than that. Yeah, like right there. These will both be iron. And these are both going to produce plates. And again, I need more reinforced plates. Alrighty, so we got that for our miner and our smelters. I'm out of cables, really. I'm just running out of everything. That's next on my list. Get our copper sorted out a little better. New, I will plug in here. Need a merger. Now we just need one of these guys. And we're good. Well, we just doubled our plate production. Next, I want to tackle copper. Copper is going to be a little more complicated. Because not only do we need wires, but we also need cables. And our power is probably getting pretty close to the limit here. Oh, maybe not, but I'm gonna grab some biomass and fill these up again. And then I'm gonna turn on a fourth burner. Alrighty, so copper. Bring out in this direction. I'm gonna need more concrete. Good thing we got that going first. And at some point, I'm gonna bring that up to the rest of the base. For the time being, I just wanna get stuff working. That guy, and then actually I'm going to turn that just a little bit because I want to put a splitter, two smelters. You guys are going to be copper. How many constructors do we need? Wire takes what, 15? Yeah. So we need 4 and then 1 for cable. And we also need a couple storage containers, and that should be it. Alrighty, so got all our materials. We are going to need more splitters. Just shove that right in there. And then we need our constructors. These are all going to be making wire for us. We need a merger. Two mergers, actually. One in there. One in there. This guy's going to be on cable duty. Alrighty, there we go. That's all set up. Let me just make a platform so I can get around it easily. Now we need to wire this all up. So for that, going to cable there, cable there. Alrighty, so these should all be powered, all be going. Those guys are all good. These guys are all good. Nice. So we got cable, we got wire. We got plates, we got concrete. So up next, we have rods and screws. Right, so this is going to be about as complicated as the wires. So I want to bring this out over here. Grab our smelters and jump off the platform. Miner. And these are going to need more splitters. You guys are going to be iron. And then how many constructors am I going to need? Am I going to need the same amount? So iron rods, I'm going to need 4 of those. And then screws, 10 per minute. I'm going to need 3 of those. So let's see, our rods hanging over the edge a little bit, but that's okay. You guys are all going to be rods. And then these two are going to merge. And these two are going to merge. And these two ones are going to split again. I want to move that merger to the other side. And these are all going to be screws. And we got to merge them again. That's not going to fit on one line, I don't think. I think it's going to need to be 2 lines. Actually, we're probably pretty close to unlocking the next tier of belts. So I am just going to merge these into one line. And we'll just do it manifold style. Just to keep it a little more compact. Then here we want our storage containers. That's all done. We just need power. So hopefully our grid can support all of this. I spoke too soon. So let's fire up another burner. And we're very quickly running out of fuel. So I want to get obstacle clearing done so we can clean out this mess. And also so we can get the biofuel. Solid biofuel. That's what we need. So we should have everything for that. Alrighty, and right here I'm just going to make myself a little pretty simple biomass automator thing. So leaves and wood. So I just want to be able to drop the raw stuff in here and it'll make its own biomass. We don't have the recipe for that yet. So this one is wood. This one is leaves. Biomass. And then biofuel is going to come out here. As soon as we get the screws we need. I'm guessing this one is backed up a little bit. Yeah. So is that one. That one not so much. All right, but with that, we can finish this. Hit our big red button. And then our next one is going to be the logistics. So you are going to make biofuel. And then I want a chainsaw. I'd like to grab some of this, and we'll go clear out some area. So you're in the way. You guys are in the way. You're gonna be in the way. These are all in the way. You're in the way. You're in the way. That's in the way. You guys are in the way. Is that everything that was absolutely in the way? I think so. Oh, nope. This stuff over here. I am gonna need a lot more biofuel, though, so I'm gonna do some clear cutting. Alrighty, so with a pocket full of debris, and stick that in there and hopefully get some biofuel. All I need to do now is sit around and make some reinforced plates, and we can get some better logistics. Alrighty, got all our plates. So let's put everything into our drop pod and send it off with that big red button. So that's going to let us improve some of the efficiency of our stuff here. Most notably, our screw production. Because right now we're limited on belt speed. And our biofuel production. Because again, on that, we're limited by belt speed. Although that's not as much of a priority. Alrighty, and our next unlock, I think, is going to be part assembly. We're pretty close to already getting that done. But let's upgrade these. So this, I believe, yep, needs 120 per minute. So we're just going to give that what it wants. This is making a lot. This is making a lot. So we're going to boost those. So to upgrade that, we need three more. Nope, three more, I said. Not three total. So that's going to help that. And then to upgrade this, we need three. There, now our screws shouldn't be bottlenecked. They should all just be flowing through. Let me empty out all of these, and then they should be good to go. And then I think everything else is fine as far as speeds go. I'm gonna move this, though. Yeah, like that. That makes more sense to me. Plus, we can now get access to this, which we're gonna need as soon as we get done with part assembly. Let's see, can we research anything here? Mycelia, probably. Yep. I think that's all we can do here for now. Alrighty, our drop pod is back. I think we have everything we need, just about. We need more cables from our copper over here. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. We're short on rods. Can I make rods? Nope. Gotta go grab rods. Okay, boom. There we go. Big red button. I'm gonna queue up the resource sink. Now, part assembly gives us access to assemblers. So we're gonna need three of these to start off with, which means we need to make 12 rotors and 24 reinforced plates. Alrighty, so with those, I think we're going to come out this direction. Part assemblers. Seems like a good spot. It's kind of out of the way just a little bit. We're going to need some storage for them. We're going to center it. So here's the center line. It's not the center line. Are these off-center? I guess they are off-center a little bit. Let's fix that. I guess these guys are just a tad bigger than a single foundation. And we just need a storage bin. Alright, this one is going to be smart plating. One of these is going to be iron plates. And one of them is going to be rotors. So 160. We're not making enough screws. We can fix that. So I need another 40 screws. And you need rods. Rods and 100 screws. Okay. So this is going to be a little bit of a mess. For the time being, I'm just going to have a bunch of stuff in there. So that'll get us some plates while I try and figure this mess out. And then you, I can fill with rods, screws, and you can do your thing. This is going to look like a total clusterfuck. Pardon my language. Right, those are good. We just need to sort out our screw situation. Get a splitter. Yeah, there we go. Nope. There we don't go. Hopefully now. Yes. Okay. So you only need 60. So we can take a 60 belt. Run it that way. So you are good to go. Then you need another 40 screws. So let me try this. Grab another constructor and a splitter. You're going to make screws. Now we need a one of these. And then this one just has to get over there. Alrighty, I think I've done it. So that should be all of our screws being processed now. And pump those in there, and we can make start making our parts. So let's see, I want to get the last two things done. So we need concrete, we need wires, we need rods, and plates. Should have everything we need. So let's get the research sink. Boom, 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 boom. Hit that big red button. And the last thing I want is jump pads and our space elevator. So we got all our burners going. We're making plenty of more fuel. Waiting on the parts for the elevator and the milestone. So let's set up an awesome sink somewhere. So we'll just kind of put it out of the way of everything else, I think. Right there looks good. Need a storage. And I want this to be as fast as possible. Now we can make tickets. I probably have some stuff I can toss in there right away. Like these frames. Goodbye, frames. Oh, goodbye, power. Looks like we need to turn on yet another burner. There's all our burners going. And we're just barely scraping by because of this thing. Let's grab what we need for a couple of things. I know we needed a bunch of wire for the elevator. And we needed a bunch of cable for some MAM research. We need 300 plates, 50 rotors. Let's do our MAM research. What was that? Alien organisms? Yeah. And we'll do that for some extra inventory space. Nice. And then I also need rods. Need a lot of plates and a lot of concrete. Alrighty, so we got what we needed for the space elevator. Let's just find a place to put it. I think right here will be good. And we're going to place it right back here, I think. Definitely not centered, but you know, whatever. We got our space elevator. This bean is in the way. Very nice. So now I'm just waiting on rotors and plates. Mostly rotors. But we do have what we need for the space elevator, so let's turn that in. Plonk it in there, seal it up, and send it off. And there it goes. Very nice. Last two plates, and we're good. Let's turn in our last milestone. Rotors, plates, cables. Hit that big red button. Alrighty, so with that done, I'm gonna call it an episode. We got our basic part assembly done to make our smart plating. And we got our basic parts pretty well organized. I mean, aside from the spaghetti mess that is over here. But everything else is in place and working to its full potential. Still got some nodes open, so we'll probably mess with those next time. Very close to coal. I want to get coal and vehicular transport ASAP, so we'll be doing that next time as well. But if you liked the video, hit me with that thumbs up. Questions, comments, suggestions, leave them below. And as always, you can hit that subscribe button for more content. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Take care. Oh. That's why. I didn't do that. Oopsies. That'll definitely help, though.